We have decided on a 10-gallon cone bottom tank for our smaller brewer, mostly because we think we found an inexpensive source for the tank. Our prototype, which will be shown here, extracts and multiplies microbes just fine. The system uses our diffusion chamber and airlift, which is a single airlift, and we hope to have something affordable by the spring of 2012. Watch microbeorganics.com. For folks who like to see a vortex, voila, a tiny glimpse. Here we'll look at the microbial results of the prototype brewer. And I think, as I said, it's at 48 hours that we took the sample. It would have been sooner, except that we were sleeping. And the dissolved oxygen measurement was 7.4 parts per million at that period of time. Here you can see some flagellates that are maneuvering around. That kind going across the top we refer to sometimes lovingly as a beach trout, and you can see a long bacteria that's moving. Some of them are moving and some of them are not. It doesn't mean that some are alive and some are dead, they just function differently. And there's some more flagellates, the larger organisms there that are moving around, and you can see another long bacteria that was moving there as well. There's also many smaller dot type bacteria. This is indicative that we have quite a diversity of bacteria, archaea. I should add that in, that the archaea are very similar, if not exactly the same looking as bacteria. So really I should the term bacteria in this should refer to both of them, because I can't tell the difference just by looking. You can find out more on that subject on the website, or just by searching, doing a Google search. So for a compost tea, you want to have some protozoa, like flagellates or naked amoeba, preferably, because those are the organisms that consume the bacteria, archaea, and then cycle the nutrients to the roots of your plants in the rhizosphere. That's zooming out as far as I can go there, and there goes another beach trout. And here we have some fungal hypha, healthy growing fungal hypha. I didn't measure this, but judging by, you know, comparing it to the size of the flagellates and bacteria, I estimate it to be approximately 5 to 7 microns in diameter. There's another of the long bacteria, mobile ones, as well as a jitterbug, or sorry, a beach trout flagellate. Multi names for these. None of them are real, though. I mean, none of the names are real. The fungal hypha is attached to a piece of organic matter, which is pretty typical. And in this case, it happens to be a sphagnum peat leaf. If you're purchasing compost tea, the person who's selling it to you should be able to illustrate something similar to this. If they don't, they shouldn't be selling the compost tea. And maybe you should just be walking away. If they're asking for more than $3 to $5 per gallon, then maybe you should be running away. This is what compost tea is all about, is the extracting and multiplying of these microorganisms which cycle nutrients in the rhizosphere and prevent disease. And do multiple other things, but I won't get into that long list right now. You might be getting bored at this stage, but I just wanted to show, oh, there's a witch's shoe. You can't have a good brew without a witch's shoe. Just a joke, of course. It's funny how certain shapes look like certain things in these stews or in these teas. In these cultures. Here's a flagellant in the later stages of division. Just need to focus in on it, or them, I should say. Once they start dividing, they divide from approximately every 2 to 4 hours, so the population can increase quite rapidly. Another beach trout. There's some more fungal hypha. For those of you who have my DVD, you realize that I've got a lot of crazy names that I've attached to some of these different protozoa, like Moustache Pete for the large ciliate with cilia on the front like a mustache. Zooming in again. You can see all of the myriads of bacteria darting around. And the long ones not darting around. Focus on the fungal hypha. And this is rare to see a live nematode at this stage. Most of them usually drown in several hours in a compost tea. But you do see the odd one that thrives or survives. So this is most of a a large size cover slip that we're going across. And there was a ciliate that just went zooming off to the left and out of view. You don't want to see tons of those, but a few of them are good. They also cycle nutrients, but too many of them is an indication that you may have some anaerobic or too many anaerobic bacteria. Plenty of fungal hypha. So what you want to see is a balanced compost tea with the bacteria archaea, the different types of protozoa, and fungal hypha. Some little strand of fungal hypha. And some more. Some more fungal hypha. Sorry I didn't dub any music in the background like a lot of folks do. I'm not very hip with how to do these videos yet. And plenty of flagellates. That's what we want to see. And there goes a ciliate and another ciliate. Here comes one back again, and the other again.